Oh, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the stream. Today, this is a spoiler alert stream. Hopefully one of the last spoiler alert streams for a while. I'm working on doing a God mode playthrough today. So I'm going to go look at like everything. This has been one of the biggest updates in quite a while. We're talking like almost a month worth of new content. I usually update like once every week. Or it was, and then lately it's been more like every 2 weeks. But this one was so huge. All the end game content, there's a new boss, all the final bosses improvements, all this new music, like all these different cutscenes for the two alternate endings. There's like so much new stuff. So all that kind of has to be tested. I have to make sure that the story elements for everything flow correctly. Nothing traps the player. There's no significant bugs. There's all that kind of stuff. I just need to do kind of like a check over of all of that kind of stuff. And also make sure the rest of the game still works too. What's up, Diamond Killer? So without further ado, I'm going to jump straight into doing that. And that is just, I'm going to take my current save file. Actually, let's back it up. Basically, I'm going to start a new save file for this playthrough test. How you doing, Dami? You encountered a bug. All right. What's that? Okay, so I got a save game ready to go. I'm going to turn off any pause. So it's not going to allow me to continue wherever the heck I say. Actually, no. This is a God mode playthrough. I want to do any pause. I'll need that today for sure. Okay, so we should be set up, ready to go. I think that's it. Let's do this. Oh, I probably should be in like... Okay, can't do permadeath. What world seed should I do today? Oh, this is a playthrough test. Okay, so I was in A. P, I think that I'm on Q now. Back. So whenever I do my playthrough tests before I do releases, I always use the sequential. Oh damn, I don't want to do story. Verbosity. What's the bug you encountered, Dami? Some weird artifacts stuff still with the intro. They're real minor though. I think I did improve the art here. I want to check this or make sure this looks good. Oh, I gotta switch to 30 frames a second. Eye in the wall boss. If you find him in the upper room, it's all fine. Sometimes when he eventually forces you out of the room, when below he doesn't come down. Oh, yeah. I've seen that before. Okay, wow. So that still happens? mark that as a note. I'm going to start taking some notes here on my phone, and I'll put that in right away. I think I've seen this before, so I don't think you have to send me a video of that. It's probably a hassle to do that. So thanks, but yeah, I've seen that before. I think I know exactly what you're talking about. So yeah, there's two kinds of situations. All right, I'll figure that out. I think hopefully that's a rare bug. It went in all the tests that I did of it, it didn't happen every time at all. Actually, it happened very rarely. And then I thought I fixed it, but I guess I didn't. So there's something there. It's still got some little bug. For some reason, the entity, it's the wall boss is really unique. It's the only boss that you fight on two different screens. So it's kind of a tricky situation to move the entity from one area to the next area and do all that. Because of the way the area transitions work in this game, it just deletes everything in the old room. So for an entity to transition between two rooms is something special. So there must be something there where it's just like somehow not getting deleted. Huh. Yeah, hopefully there's this one thing I did today that might have fixed that. I've just been thinking about that. What's up, Retronator? Hey, Retronator, how you doing, man? Retronator. Dead end. All right, lots of testing to get done today. I gotta do at least two dungeons at the beginning, and then at least the last two dungeons as well. So like, I gotta get through four dungeons here in today's stream. Yeah, right on, catch the stream. Oh yeah, there's a lot of new stuff. So in general, what's new in this version I'm testing right now is the ending. So the game has two endings. It depends on, there's one thing you can do in the game where if you do it, I won't ruin it or whatever, I won't tell you what it is. But if you do it, it changes the ending of the game. So this update's pretty huge in that it has the whole ending. The final boss has really been improved. And there's another new boss in the ending dungeon. And yeah, I've been working on this update for the last month. This is the biggest update I've done in pretty much the project's history of being on Steam. So I'm pretty excited to finally get this out. Yeah, and that's, I know what you mean. Yeah, when you leave the room, right when it lets you, I know what you mean. Yeah. Sometimes what actually happens there is that he gets respawned where he was, where he originally starts. So he's actually at the very top of the screen again, on the other screen but behind you. So it actually takes a while, and then he finally comes back on the screen. I've seen that before. So there's like three different bugs. It's like the bug happens in three different ways. I didn't even pay attention to where I should turn off regular HUD mode. This will help. I'm kind of lost. I'm like, where am I? Okay, so lots of testing to get done. That's why I'm just going to turn into God mode here. Okay, good. Got this situation happening. Oh, sweet. Forgot it. Dude, that's pretty cool. So you can do the sword attack on him. Ah, that's cool. Or the sword ring, the sword clash. That's pretty cool. So that's a new thing with the latest newest boss. It's a sword fighting boss. So yeah, I wanted to have some swords clashing and clanging sounds going on, and a really cool effect for when two swords hit each other. I don't know why that bug. Actually, that's probably a bug. Yeah, this guy probably shouldn't do that sword clashing sound because he doesn't have a sword. Let me make a note of that. Alright, taking notes, listing out the bugs. Gotta get lots of stuff fixed. Drop mini boss can clang sword. And that is a super important one because it has to do with what I'm looking on today. Tonight's release. Okay, another bug noted. I think I'm gonna just save these links for later because I'm streaming right now. I'll download these later in case, I don't know, in case that affects the stream or if it would have. Cool, thank you, man. Appreciate it. Oh, there it is. Cool. Found Dungeon 1! Yes! Wait, was there music there? Cool, I forgot about that little new animation. Okay, so this little sequence right here. This would be sweet if it. Had letterboxing. Actually, it'd be really cool if Jib had a sound right there. Okay, I was not supposed to walk through that wall, so... Okay, did this the right way now. So if you're just joining the stream, what I'm working on here is doing like a play. I'm doing a God mode playthrough. I'm just doing basically a play test. I'm going through the whole, or as much of the game as I can, to look for any bugs in the new version that I've been working on the last month. Grip Gary, what's up, man? How you doing today, Gary? Doing good, right on. Chaos Gaming, what's up, man? How's it going? Oh! got killed. Oh, it's so funny. I got killed by the first boss. How long has it been since that happened? That's so great. Oh, now I got no bombs? What? So I picked up the bombs during that run. It's supposed to recharge your bombs. Oh man, that's probably a bug. Should write that down. Okay, well, I gotta take a look at that. It's supposed to, if you die, and you picked up some bombs during your run that time, it should replenish those bombs, because... Just because that's the game's forgiving like that. Well, sometimes it's good to die. Okay, proceed. Okay, so there's so many worms on the ground that it's slowing down the game. I keep forgetting to like note this. There's too many boss worms. Nice. You hit him just right. That's cool. Right on, Dami. Yeah. I love those moments when you're like, yes! This just happened. Finally got the blink orb, man. I feel normal again. Whoa, is there really? Oh, interesting. What? They put this pattern out here and here. Oh, okay. Well, that's 12-0-0. 12-0-0 world Q. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Q. 12-0-0 has a second drop mini boss. And it's on top of a store. This is freaking weird. This is a weird screen. Oh, how do you get a free copy of the game? You mean like for raffling points? That doesn't work anymore. Sorry. Bot Fu is kill. All right, well, I definitely want to buy one of these. And definitely buy this. This is my favorite thing. Oh. By the way, I was just thinking, the Jib Shield, I want to make sure that's not too expensive. I think it might be too expensive. Yeah, see, it's like 160. It's way too expensive for the Jib Shield. It should be more like 90. It's around like 80 or 90, like a bomb container. So basically, the Jib Shield and the Top Hat Magnet should be something where you're kind of like debating, like, oh, which one should I buy? Or, you know, something like that. So instead of it being 160, where you're probably not going to have that after a single dungeon, unless you really were thorough during that dungeon. So I think getting the Jib Shield a little earlier, a little easier, a little more affordable is going to be good. So let me make the note of that in the change log. Oh yeah, that's on my list too. Sorry about that. So it's a little bit too easy to just buy stuff. So I'm gonna make it a little bit more confirmy or something in there. That's on my list. All right, we gotta get to dungeon two. Gotta do this. Gotta be a secret right here. Yeah. Wow, this is the second boss where it's in kind of a weird location. But I like these. I kind of like these paths where you've got this boss where it's not quite a dead end. It actually is kind of cool how it changes the world that way. Yeah, it's definitely gonna help. Oh, you know what? I did not want to do this dungeon. I'm gonna rip through this dungeon as fast. In fact, oh, what? Oh, now it's open. Oh, maybe I had invincibility on. Yeah. Oh, forgot about this one. New cutscene. I forgot about this. Yes. Oh, right, all the secrets? Totally, right? Yeah, you keep on looking for secrets? Nice. Kukuriku, what's up, man? Okay, so this one also, this is the... This scene, I want to be letterboxed as well. Cool. I love how that story element happens right there, because it's different than, you know, it's not at the beginning of the dungeon or the end of the dungeon or whatever. It's a bit staggered. Nice, more bombs. Love bombs. What's this? Oh no! That's not supposed to happen. You're not supposed to be able to sword clash off of those guys either. So I need to add to my other note. There's like a note I have already about, where is that? There it is. Draw mini boss King Clang sword and the ice dragons. That should be a pretty easy fix. Just making sure to check what collision category they have before doing the sword clash. Right now it checks, okay, it has to have a friend and a foe to be able to do a sword clash, but really it needs to have two swords. Like, I don't even know what's going on right here. Causing bugs with the whole sword clash. Because it has an attack opponent. These guys have attack opponents, so does the player. Hero. What is this? Okay. What's up, the Ragna? Thank you, man. Thank you for pre-ordering. I really appreciate that. Oh, because I went this way. That's crazy. This dungeon is kind of weird how that works, right? I went through this secret wall here, but because it's like got this secret puzzle thing, or this puzzle one-way puzzle thing, it makes for an interesting dungeon that you never would have planned. That's the beauty of procedural generation. stuff like that that surprises you. Okay, Lusorium. Okay, so fixing the sword clashes is going to be one of the most important bugs to fix, because there's only one enemy, really, that's what you're supposed to do the sword clash off of, and that's the boss that fights with his sword. I don't have any cactuses. What? Not what I need to be testing anyway, so I'm just gonna cheat my way through this boss, because I gotta go get to the end of the game now, where I'm also gonna have to cheat a lot, because I will not have anywhere near the items I need to beat the final bosses. In fact, maybe I'll just edit my save game and cheat a bit to do that. Okay, good. So it's good when you don't notice any bugs. I haven't noticed any bugs in a minute. Oh, right. Yeah, there you go. Okay, I at least need to go do the first swordless dungeon. Well, that's funny. Yeah. Okay, so those need to start apart. Alright, so that is a bug. When you warp back from Songbringer, you can land back on these gold container things. Okay, so I gotta go find the swordless dungeon. Is that gonna be? Thank you. There he is. What's up, Zero? Guide me, my spirit guide. So you have to get the ghost sword to be able to find the first swordless dungeon in this world. Oh, maybe not. Maybe he just took me around the long way. Where'd he go? Yeah, I think this is just the long way. Alright, now I got cactuses, this is really gonna help. In fact, maybe I'll, in this next dungeon, I'll make sure to steal the other cactus pouch. Whoops. I don't want to cheat that much. There it is. Oh no, the puzzle thing isn't going off. Wait. No. Oh, the switches aren't turning on either. Damn. Okay, so that's a big bug. Well, not a big bug. I mean, it should be a pretty fast fix, but that is super important. This is why I'm glad I do some testing. Swordless dungeon fire pillars don't trigger switch is okay. I gotta move that to like the top of the list. That definitely has to be done tonight before I release. Okay, so that means that all this dungeon is gonna be. Can't get the meditate skill? Give me a break. Well, okay. Since I noted the bug, I'm gonna save here and hack my save game. Poop Galactic, it is. God mode actually is really fun. I'm trying to think of some way I could actually make this part of the game somehow. It's like if you could do God mode, and also speeding up time is really, really fun. When everything's all fast, you're like, what's going on? So we need switch 3-1 2 and 3. Oops. So it's shadow too. Shadow during meditate. Offset is wrong somehow. Okay, so yeah, his shadow should be higher up right there so it doesn't look all weird like it does. Man, compared to how it was like 3 months ago, the game's story has really started to play out and unfold more than it used to. So now that all the story elements are pretty much complete, man, this is really a huge relief. It's like the story's done. This is great. For the most part. So yeah, that's the rest of today's playthrough in God mode. I've got to go test the last two dungeons. So I may have to cheat and find some items and stuff. Or steal some items or something like that. Okay, so I have meditate. Let me check this out, make sure this works. You hate the ghost thing so much? In a good way? I know, right? Lots of people say that. You want extra difficulty mode? Oh, Coast Edge, what's up, man? Thanks, man. Right? The Witcher Development Syndrome? Let me check this out later on. Oh, it's a JPEG? Wait, I can see it now? Oh, oh man. Even little story elements like that where Jib says something after you meditate, it really helps the story of the game like feel complete. It's very satisfying. Okay, so I gotta find the tower. Oh, I already know where the tower is. So I gotta do Songbringer Dungeon. Oh, you have to craft at least one item to do that, so I do have to cheat. I definitely have to give myself, like, two elements. If I want to get through these last dungeons, I've got to have two elements. Ice is probably a good one to have. I know, right? Yeah. It's tough working so much. I don't work 14 hours a day. I definitely work 9 hours, 10 hours a day. I do work 7 days a week. I work too much. Just like all the game developers, it seems like. Right? So let me get ice. Maybe poison. Whatever, poison. AKA acid. Okay, so I need to craft a couple items, trigger the smith quest, do the Songbringer dungeon, and then do the final dungeon. And really, the point of doing all this is mostly to check over all the story elements to make sure everything happens correctly. Because there's just so much new story at the very end. Okay, I'm thinking I will do top hat, poison. Ahoy, what's up, Salad Dongs? Oh, right, the ice, yeah. The ice is meant to be a gate item and a weapon and a bunch of other things. What's up, the Gel Mega? Hello. You chilling right on, Salad? Welcome. How's your day going? Besides the chilling. Let me get this. Okay, so we'll do a ghost sword now with ice. Oh, I gotta go out of the room. I forgot about this. Okay, so this is about to trigger like all of the game's ending story elements. Thank you. super cool. Nice one. Playing catch up with school, right on. Happy Sunday. Hello, everybody on the stream. Hope y'all are having a nice Sunday. I'm having a nice Sunday, too. It's a little bit of pressure because I got my release to do tonight, but, you know, releases are a good thing. It's like you get everything polished up with the game, and then you update it, and oh no. Oh, it's not triggering. Well, this is a... Glad I'm testing this. Oh, what? Okay, let's figure out why. It's already Monday there. Happy Monday, everybody. Happy Monday and Sunday. Okay, so another bug. Let me note that. And turn on story verbosity so I can figure out why that's not triggering, because that might be a quick fix. Let's hope this is a quick fix. Oh man, it triggered fine that time. Okay, so I got a note bug. Oh, maybe that's supposed to, that might be how it's supposed to work. You craft something, then you go back to the world, you use it for a while, and then it triggers the last thing. Oh, but I still need to check this. Because that might be a bug. Is it a bug that Smith Quest didn't trigger after crafting? But not leaving SP and coming back. This might be what it is. Cool. At least this part's working. What's up, Hank and Megum? Yeah, the game's been in beta for about a year. This is 3 years into developing Songbringer, and it's coming out this summer. So it will be released this summer, 2017, and it's coming out for Steam. What? Oh no, you can. That was weird, like they're still getting hit there for a second. Yeah, the game's coming out for Steam, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One all this summer. Yeah. Oh, that story element should not happen after you've crafted. So let's teleport. Happened after crafting in SB dungeon. So that story element just shouldn't play, basically, after you've already crafted. Oh yeah, Pook. This boss fight has been improved a lot in this version. So I'm about to fight this boss here, and there's some significant improvements because before, one of the biggest problems with that that boss fight was that you couldn't do diagonal blinks. Now what happens if you do a diagonal blink and you can't end up at that diagonal position? It actually tries to do a cardinal blink instead, a right angle blink. And that basically makes it so whenever you're using the blink, you're actually pressing a dirt in a direction, it will pretty much get you going that direction even if you weren't entirely accurate with it. So when you're using like a controller and you're using an analog stick and the stick's like at 30% is not quite like, you know what I mean? Sometimes you can get those northwest, northeast, southwest, and southeast angles, and they will still work just as fine now with the blink. So that's will really help fighting the lightning boss. There's another couple huge improvements to this version of Songbringer as far as the lightning boss goes too. First of all, you get the flask a lot easier now. You need to have a flask pretty much for the end game. And also, what's the other big one with that boss? Oh, I fixed a few bugs. Like she used to be able to do several spirals at once, but now she can only do her two spirals if she is low of hit points. So basically there's a lot of improvements to make her more reasonable. Before, she was a little bit too difficult. Yeah, that's just Salad. That's just a bitmap font, and that's a language, not a language, but an alphabet that I wrote a long time ago for my tattoos. And I was like, well, since I already wrote this alphabet, I should use it in a video game, I guess. What's up, Cropper? How fun is it to make achievements? It's really fun. Yeah, cool, nice. Yeah, it wasn't just you being bad at the game. That was a overly difficult boss because of those problems. Like Dishonored? I don't know. I haven't played Dishonored. I'm not sure. Let me show you what the blink is. It's like this. You can teleport forward. Oh, it did two of those? I gotta write that down too. It just did that story element twice. So let's teleport happened in the Songbringer dungeon, and it happened for both ice and acid or something like that. Okay, so proceed. Where are we going here? Up to the left. Run away! You should be able to see the achievements in Steam. Yeah, they're there. Oh, maybe not. I don't know. Can you see them? Maybe it's a developer-only thing for me for now. I don't know. I've been getting all. I know other people are getting the achievements, or they used to be. Are you sure? Yeah, so here's all my achievements. I've got 22 out of 42 achievements already. Still got some work left to do with those. And also, you can always just go to the achievements. Oh, I just closed Steam. Well. I just noticed one little thing about her. Oops, that one was lightning. Lightning boss, easy. Disappear. This is just animate, disappear, zero. Wait, can you destroy her? Oh, I don't have the chip or the... supposed to disappear at some point. Oh, this doesn't matter. This is not important. Okay, I'm just running away. Run away! It's not important. It's not as important as testing the rest of the game. Oh, wait. Was I supposed to go in here? Spoiler alert! Stop watching if you care about spoilers. Shouldn't be watching any of this stream if you care about spoilers. There's a big spoiler alert in the title. I think that door was okay, like it was, I was supposed to be able to go through there. Let's just go take a look at... What? This is like, oh. Nice. You can't view them all. Oh, I think that might be because it's still in beta. I don't know. Yeah, oh, right. Okay, so that's how it works, Close Edge. So you can't view the achievements until the game is actually released, but you can actually get the achievements. That's what I thought. I mean, I didn't know this part, but like, thank you for clarifying that. I thought that about the, I thought that you were actually getting the achievement. That's cool. What are the past games I've worked on? None you've heard of. I have not been a successful developer yet in my life. But hopefully I will be. I guess it depends on what you consider success. But my last video game was called Hero Bash. It was a multiplayer MOBA for iOS. And it was a flop. But it taught me some of the most important lessons I ever learned in game development. Especially in indie game development. gonna go ahead and cheat to beat this boss. I'm gonna cheat to beat all the bosses because I don't have much time. Let's make sure these story elements work. So one problem with that, the boss music restarted. After lit boss steals segue. I hope so. I hope so, Pook. Thanks, man. Appreciate that. I hope so. I don't have a profile on Moby Games. No, what's that? What's Moby Games? Should I save the smith, or should I kill the smith? Y'all get a different ending. I guess Smith's coming with me. I already got him. Yeah, you're guaranteed to have some flops. Yeah. Oh. Kill him? Oh, I already saved him. Oh, cool. Shave the smith. A note there? Picked up the smith, that was fine. The teleporter. I guess I was fine. Okay, well, we're down to the last dungeon now. I found the tower. Oh, I did find the tower. It's up there. All right, let's do this. Oh, wait, but I gotta get Bell. Say what? Samurai Jack? That's cool. I haven't watched much of Samurai Jack. I should really check that out. I only watched like the first couple episodes like 5 years ago or something. I should check that out. Yeah, yeah, totally. Flopping versus scoring is a big difference, but as long as you learn from each one of your flops, I think that's the most important thing, right? There's really no such thing as a failure. There's only a lesson success. At least that's the way I like to think of it. It's a success that you successfully learned a lesson. You know, it sounds like it's just a half glass empty, half full thing. But anyways, if you look at the glass, however you look at the glass, as long as you go and learn your lesson from each one of your failures or flops or whatever you consider them, then you're making progress. Nice. Yay, cool, your window works. Yeah, lots of feedback really helps. It does. That's been a really big benefit of doing the live streams for Songbringer, is just that there's been direct feedback from all you guys, the entire project. So I'll make something, I'll do a live stream and get immediate feedback, which helps a lot. This whole project would not be what it is without the live stream. So thank you guys once again. The Kickstarter wouldn't have succeeded without the live stream either. And then, so basically Songbringer would not have been made if I hadn't have done a live stream or if you guys hadn't watched. So thanks for watching. Sweet. I love all this new dialogue. It really works well. Finally, Vel's character is how she's meant to be. And the whole plot of the entire game is just like really cemented now. The whole reasoning behind why you're fighting the enemies you are, it all makes sense now. Is that Brutus? Can we not talk to Brutus? I guess you can't talk to Brutus while you got Vel. Oh, maybe you can. Oh, cool. So you can get the Smith quest even if you have Vel. Thanks. You did? You got the go for your next studio? Dude, that's great. Congratulations, Dami. It's awesome. Yeah, you need her to beat the game. And you do not have to get her this way. There are other ways to unlock her. Gonna make sure this Brutus quest works as well. Where was he? Over here? There he is. Okay, so we got the empty flask. That quest worked. But there's one little issue there. It said Gurk. Gurk. Happened before Smith quest finished. Should be a pretty easy one, too. All right, Gel Mega, see you, man. Now I feel well equipped for the final boss fight. Well, not well equipped, but a minimum, we have a minimum amount of equipment to do this. Alright, final dungeon. So this is the most important stuff to check because this is where everything changed in this latest update. This whole dungeon is it's been really refined a lot. Definitely under-equipped. Did he restore my items? I barely have any. I did not restore the items again! Something happened there. Yeah, maybe it did. I don't know. Did I have two of those? Do I still enjoy playing it after all this time? It's funny. Yes, I actually do. Totally, this totally happens in game development, right? You get sick of playing your own game. But I'm lucky because I have kind of like set things up so I only have to play Songbringer really like every 2 weeks, right? So I'll spend 2 weeks on development where I'm mostly just like firing up the game, fixing a bug, and then, you know, I'm done. Or firing up the game, working on one specific creative element for a while. And then I'm done. So I never really play the game that much, you know. I have to do like playthroughs like this every like 2 weeks, so I don't get tired of it that much. And since it's like my dream game, like a Zelda-like game, it's procedurally generated. It's still been fun for me this whole project. So I think that's good if you're an indie developer to like set up some kind of schedule where you only have to play your game every once in a while, and it can really help if you also hire out some Q&A and things like that. I'm lucky because also I have an amazing publisher, and they are doing some Q&A as well as, you know, I do my own Q&A here, as you're obviously seeing, but like, it's just really nice to be backed by a team of people that are helping you out and also have, you know, lots of fans looking at the game too. So there's lots of people playing the game, playing the beta and taking a look at things. So I don't feel so much pressure that I have to do as much, or I have to do all the testing that I would do if this were I'm very humbled to be at this level of whatever this is. What's up, Pixels? Nice. So yeah, you got your formalities and assignments. Sweet. You even have a workspace? Dang, that's awesome, Tommy. What the? I have like way too little health right here. Maybe I should just cheat and get some more health. I kind of want to do this boss fight though, because this is a pretty important one. I think that blob is stuck on the freaking... It's stuck. It's making this fight really easy. I need to write this down. Okay. Blob boss 2 got stuck on light pillar. Nice. Okay, so this is a pretty reasonable boss fight. In fact, I can pretty easily defeat this guy, even with way too little health. So that's good. Alright, floor 1, that seemed pretty reasonable. There's no significant bugs or anything. What the heck is wrong with this guy? This guy's really easy. This boss fight is super easy. He's not doing any of his fire attacks. Why aren't you doing any of your fire attacks, Mr. Fire Boss? Wow, okay. That's another bug. God. Sometimes I feel like I'm drowning in bugs. Fire boss in tower doesn't have any fire. D&D? I actually have never played D&D. Yes! Okay, so this guy is totally buggy. I don't know why, but he's not even doing any of his fire attacks. Okay, so floor two, that was a pretty big bug with the fire boss just being so disabled, but it should be quite easy to fix. Something just got awry. This boss fight in particular, pretty important to take a look at. This is one of the new ones. Nice. Oh, don't tell me I gotta start all the way over. Ah, damn. Now they're doing fire. Now they're doing all their attacks? Come on. Why do you work all of a sudden? One little issue where Keel gets kind of stuck on Vel somehow. Super strong, forgot. Is Songbringer self-published? Not entirely, no. I have an indie publisher that's helping me get on PlayStation and Xbox, and they've helped me get to events like PAX and GDC, and they've been helping out with funding. Speedrunners would, right? But that would kind of ruin the challenge of speedrunning, right? If you had God mode. Thank you. Whoa, I got knocked into the corner. That has been happening lately. Hard when you don't have any of the items you would need. Like, you definitely need a chip, or the glove, or both, or the shield, or lots more health. Like, I only have like dungeon 3 worth of health. So this is hard as shit. But I'm just gonna cheat. You gotta go fast, right? Wait, did it do the dialogue? I can't remember if it did the dialogue there when I killed him. Here we go, final boss. Whoops. I forgot I got rid of... Oh, damn. That's pretty important. This is supposed to be a... what was it called? A refill. It's supposed to be a refill right here. That is also very important. Because otherwise you can't warp from here to the overworld and refill your flask and do everything else you need to do before fighting the final boss. Only one? No, I've never played that. Never heard of it. What's it about? I'm just gonna cheat and save here, though. Save there! Final boss. Weird. I used the super bomb there. It should have destroyed those. Should have destroyed those pillars. Okay. He's in his second phase, but he hasn't done his grow thing yet. He's supposed to grow a little big. Oh, there he goes. Okay, so it's starting to work again. It's like a knight with a sword declaring he's the only one. Like Highlander? Oh, it's wave-based? Oh, cool. Okay, so I got some ideas on how this guy can be better. I think I'll probably spend like a good 2 days making this boss even better. I think he needs one more. It gets too repetitive here because you keep fighting him the exact same way. So I want his second mode to be a lot different. Like, he goes into three phases, and I want the second or maybe the third phase to be something where it's just so different that it's like, all right, this feels like a completely different boss fight. What needs to happen here, so it just feels a little more refreshing. Thank you. not finish his animation that looked all funny. That time he finished it. Sank off the edge. That was another bug. He's not supposed to be able to sink. Alright, here goes the ending sequence. Let's make sure this all works, nothing breaks, the story all happens. Save and quit right here. I need to be able to like disable the save and quit or something right there at the end. It's another kind of important thing, but I guess it's not so important. You could save during the credits and it wouldn't be that bad. All right, let's do this. Oh, it's been a month. Yeah, I've been working on these sections for an entire month, just making sure all these story elements work correctly. Writing, creating all these story elements took an entire month. But just so you know, got stuck there. I think I already noted that bug. Alright, so here comes the outro. Thanks, man. Good. So it's doing the correct ending for whether I save Smith or not. So I save Smith. So Smith saves Jib. That's really great. Yeah, you can skip it, Kosaj. You just hold down a button to skip if you really want to. So I probably noted like 20 bugs or something crazy. So I imagine maybe like 5 to 10 of them are things that I've got to get done tonight before I update or before I release this beta update. So that's what I'll be working on tonight, and then hopefully I get this all finished by tonight. Right, yeah. And for speedrunners too, if you're speedrunning the game, like, you're not going to want to see the story every time. So that's why there's the button. And if you just hold down B during any one of the cutscenes, you can skip them. Yeah, UK. Yep, they're from the UK. They're called Double 11. And they have done some notable titles they brought to consoles, like Limbo. They were the ones that did Limbo for consoles. They did Goat Simulator, Prison Architect, Pixel Junk Shooter. Like, they've done a lot of different games recently. Yeah, so they have their own custom engine for, you know, PlayStation and Xbox and all that. Really lucky to be able to use that, use their engine to get the game on PlayStation and Xbox. So I rewrote the credits so you can hold down a button to skip through if you're like, oh, I don't really need to see this. If you don't want to see the credits, you can just hold down the button. Or if you want to skip to your name, like, you're like, oh, I really want to see my name. Oh, they're not alphabetical though. I probably should alphabetize those. So if you want to skip to your name, you can. You only need legs to kick ass. I forgot about that one. Okay, I guess this would alphabetize the credits. That's not an immediately important bug to fix, though. The driving segments. Yeah, that'd be lovely. I would love to do that sometime. How do you spell the publisher? Their name is Double 11. go. All right, so that's it. AKA four ones, or maybe 22. Well, okay, so I got a lot of work to do ahead of me tonight to get this release out. On top of all those bugs that I just mentioned that I have to fix, I have a release to prepare, so I got to get going and get this out, because man, it's been like freaking a month. I just can't wait to get this release out and be like, all right, it's done. Yes. So anyways, thanks for watching. Hope you all have a great night. And we'll see y'all next time.